Have you been eager to get pregnant and you saw some blood in your underwear? And you're not sure, you're trying to work out, is this what they call an implantation bleed? Or is it another disappointment and just another period? Hi ladies, I'm Dr. Kady. I'm a board certified family doctor. Welcome to Hey Doc. On this channel, we discuss things health, but more specifically, we talk around women's health as well as fertility medicine. If you're new on here, welcome, and we hope that the content on this channel will make you consider subscribing. Keep watching. As mentioned before, this video is about the implantation bleed and whether the blood that you're seeing in your underwear is a period. We'll go into details about it, but I encourage you all to stick to the very end of the video because I will share with you important red flags about all forms of vaginal bleeding that all women must be aware of. So make sure you don't miss out by watching the video right through till the end. In this video, I will give you a background education into the menstrual cycle, what happens after fertilization has occurred. I will tell you what an implantation bleed is. I will also go into details about the specific characteristics of an implantation bleed that you need to consider. Then I will talk about the signs and the symptoms of a period, which will then allow us to compare and contrast between an implantation bleed and a period. Let's build a foundation around the menstrual cycle, ovulation, and fertilization of an egg. On day one of your menstrual cycle, which remember is the first day of the bleed, follicles which contains the egg are found in your ovaries. They will start to grow right from day one, and they will continue to do so for the next couple of days. What stimulates the growth of these follicles is a hormone known as estrogen. And as the estrogen levels continue to rise and reaches its peak, it will lead to the full maturation of the follicles. Then comes along another hormone known as luteinizing hormone. What is particular and specific about this hormone is that its levels rise and fall quickly. The rapid rise of this hormone is known as the LH surge. And it is this LH surge that provokes the release of an egg from one of the follicles, which has continued to mature over the past couple of days. Quite simply, the high level of LH will cause one of these follicles to burst open and release an egg. And this process is known as ovulation. The released egg will remain in the fallopian tube until it meets with a sperm cell, which is known as fertilization. The combination of the egg and the sperm coming together will start to form a mass of cells that will continue to multiply on their own until it reaches a stage where this mass of cells is known as a blastocyst. This blastocyst is an early stage of an embryo. The blastocyst will then start to swiftly move further along the fallopian tube until it reaches the endometrium in the main uterine cavity. Once the blastocyst reaches the endometrium, it will start to implant itself into the structure of the endometrium. This moves us very swiftly into talking about what an implantation bleed is. When the blastocyst starts to implant itself into the uterine cavity, it actually causes a disruption in the engorged blood vessels that are found within the endometrium. This causes minor bleeding, which is experienced by the woman as spotting, and often leaves women perplexed as to whether this is an early sign of pregnancy or this is the beginning of just another period. You might be thinking, what is all this about? I've fallen pregnant before and I've never experienced any spotting. And so I've never had to think of the concept of an implantation bleed. Whoa, this is all new to me, you might be thinking. You're right, not every woman will experience an implantation bleed. But the fact that you never had it before in your other pregnancies doesn't mean to say that you may not experience it with your following pregnancies. So that's why this video is aimed at empowering you just in case you see some spotting in your underwear for you to know whether this is an early sign of pregnancy, even if you have never experienced spotting or bleeding in your previous pregnancy, or for you to know that the spotting that you're experiencing in that cycle is a period and that you are not yet pregnant. So having said all of that, we can see that implantation bleeding is a very non-specific sign of early pregnancy. Some women get it, some women don't. The same woman may experience it in one pregnancy and may not experience it in another pregnancy. So we cannot rely on implantation bleeding to confirm a pregnancy. But it can be a useful sign of early pregnancy when it does happen, especially for the ladies that are a little bit apprehensive as to whether or not they are pregnant because they've been eager in trying to fall pregnant and the urine pregnancy test is not yet giving them a strong second line which would confirm that there is a pregnancy. So for those ladies, whilst they wait for a strong positive pregnancy test, this implantation bleeding can sometimes be a source of hope. So when implantation bleeding does occur, we can use it to our advantage. But we must know more about its characteristics in order to be in a position where we are more assertive to say, yep, this is an implantation bleed. Yay! Knowing about the characteristics of an implantation bleed will prevent us from being disappointed later on when we find out that actually it was just the start of another period. So the first characteristics that we will consider of an implantation bleed is its timing. Implantation bleed will tend to happen 6 to 12 days after fertilization has happened. Because remember, the fertilized egg, which has now become an embryo, has to travel all the way down the fallopian tube and into the uterine cavity. So this journey can take quite a number of days. And what happens and what causes even more confusion for some ladies is that this time that it takes for the egg to start to implant itself can be around the time when they would naturally be expecting a period, causing even more confusion. But stick with me. Let's keep going. It will become clearer. The second characteristic is around the appearance of the bleeding. Implantation bleeding is lighter than a regular period, and as the days go on and spotting may last for a couple of days, the bleeding tends to stay rather light and start to diminish with time. I touched a little bit about amount, but the third characteristic is the amount. How much bleeding is there? When you go and see your doctor and tell him about your bleeding and we're not sure whether this is a period or an implantation bleed, one of the first things that your doctor is going to ask you is how much bleeding is happening. Implantation bleeding is usually minimal. It either stays the same way as it was when it first started and then stops, or as the days go by, it starts to get lighter and lighter until it stops. That's why, medically speaking, we often refer to this type of vaginal bleeding as spotting. Then there is the duration of the bleeding. Implantation bleeding can last anything from a few hours to a maximum of around 3 days. But by the time you have gotten to the third day, the bleeding is usually so light that it looks like very, very pinkish discharge. And by day three, it has almost stopped completely. Another symptom that can happen with implantation bleeding is cramping. But very often, the cramping is quite subtle. And in some women, the cramping may be so negligible that it may go unnoticed or quite simply dismissed as the type of cramping that they experience before the next period is about to start. And in some cases of women that have implantation bleeding, there may not be any cramping at all. Having said that, when it comes to vaginal spotting and low abdominal cramping, especially when you're trying to get pregnant or you're a woman in your reproductive years who may not have used any contraception and there is a possibility that you might be pregnant, and we're talking about cramping in the lower abdomen, this is a reminder for you to stick with me right through to the end of this video where I will be sharing that life-saving piece of information. I'm sure someone is thinking, why not just go and do a pregnancy test instead of going through this checklist and going through all this period of apprehension, thinking, am I pregnant? Am I not pregnant? Surely doing a pregnancy test will be easier. Not really. Here's why. Pregnancy tests detect the presence of a hormone known as HCG. This is a hormone that is produced during pregnancy. After implantation has happened, the HCG levels can take some time before they rise and become detectable in the blood and in the urine. By the way, beta HCG is detectable in the blood much sooner than it is in the urine. So this then leads me to talking about the concept of a false negative result. If a woman does a pregnancy test too early, the result may simply be negative, but this will be a false negative because the beta HCG levels have not risen to high enough levels for it to be detected in the urine. So although she may be pregnant, the beta HCG levels are just not detectable. Now, false negative can have significant implications. I'll explain. Say, for example, a woman has done a pregnancy test and it's come back as negative. Remember, this negative test may be because it was performed too early. If she just relies on this negative pregnancy test and, for example, is awaiting important treatment like chemotherapy or radiotherapy, and she does a pregnancy test and it's negative, and she goes ahead with this sort of treatment, it's not just chemotherapy or radiotherapy, so other treatments are too destructive for a developing fetus and will need to be delayed until the woman is further on in a pregnancy or has been delivered of the baby. If she relies on this false negative result and goes ahead with this treatment, the treatment may be too destructive to the developing fetus, leading to a miscarriage. And this can be quite heartbreaking when the woman has been trying to fall pregnant for some time. Being aware of this concept of false negative pregnancy tests can empower you to make better decisions about things like treatment, even when you have had a negative pregnancy test. My advice is that if you've been trying to get pregnant, or even if you're not trying, but you have a suspicion that you had an implantation bleed and you are not too sure whether or not you're pregnant, wait a couple of days. I would say wait another five to seven days, and then go to your doctor. Rather than doing another urine pregnancy test, what would be more reliable is doing a blood beta HCG levels. Because remember, I mentioned that the beta HCG levels are detected in the blood sooner than they are in the urine. So when you are in the situation where you need to confirm a pregnancy sooner rather than later, because it's having implication on other decisions that you will have to take, wait a while. If you have had what you perceive might be an implantation bleed, wait a couple of days, then go to your doctor and do a blood test. That will remove the confusion that may be associated with getting a false negative pregnancy test. Now, let's move on to talking about the characteristics of a period, which will hopefully help you to differentiate between an implantation bleed and a period. And I'm hoping that this will save you not only the cost of buying a pregnancy test, but also the emotional trauma that is associated with not knowing whether this is an implantation bleed or another period, and all the anxiety and apprehension that come along with that. So for those of you who are blessed with having regular period, the bleeding of a period will tend to start round about the days when you are expecting another period, plus or minus a few days. Typically, the bleeding will last anything between 4 to 7 days. The bleeding, although would have started as a light pinkish discharge, will start to get heavier, and you're going to need to change your pad or your tampon a few times that day. And as the days follow, you're definitely going to get more copious blood, and you're changing your sanitary towel or your tampon a lot more often. This is in comparison to the implantation bleed, where you are just needing a panty liner. You're not really needing a pad or a tampon. It's just a panty liner, which you may need to change once or not at all. And if you are a woman who really bleeds heavily during your period, you may even start to experience the clots a few hours after having started bleeding. Now, a little twist in the matter is that you may have gone past the stage of early pregnancy and you are still spotting. Or the spotting has graduated to bleeding a little bit more heavily. At this stage, it has been confirmed that you are pregnant. You have had an ultrasound to confirm that the baby is indeed in the uterine cavity and it's in the right position. If you are experiencing bleeding even after a pregnancy has been confirmed, I want to reassure you that there are more women than we think that bleed throughout their pregnancy. However, I do want to encourage you not to take any form of bleeding during your pregnancy lightly. If that's you, like I said, a lot of women bleed in their pregnancy and the baby is fine, but you must reach out to your obstetrician who may need to do a series of ultrasound scan because often there is what is known as a perigestational bleed, which is a small sac of blood that sits within the uterine cavity throughout the pregnancy. And it bleeds bit by bit as the pregnancy progresses. But the importance of doing a series of ultrasound scan is to ensure sac of blood doesn't get bigger, doesn't affect the well-being of the baby. But as long as it remains stable, and more often than not, this sac of blood tends to get smaller as the pregnancy progresses. So as long as that's the case for you and the bleeding doesn't cause you any pain and the baby has been confirmed to be well after a series of ultrasound scan, you have nothing to worry about. Now, on to the important piece of information I promised you earlier in the video. If you are a woman who's spotting, and you are in your reproductive years, and there is a possibility that you might be pregnant. Sadly, if you suddenly start to experience severe lower abdominal pain, especially if it's on one side, but it doesn't have to be on the one side, but in the lower abdomen, in the pelvic area, and the pain is severe, we worry about the embryo having implanted in the fallopian tube rather than having traveled down the fallopian tube into the uterine cavity as it's supposed to. And this is an ectopic pregnancy, which is life-threatening. If that is you, you are spotting and experiencing sudden onset of severe lower abdominal pain, life-saving advice is get to your doctor immediately and discuss with your doctor whether this might be a sign of an ectopic pregnancy. As always, here is a word from God. As you continue to trust Him and have faith that He alone is able to bless you with the fruit of the womb. I share from Psalm 128, verse 3. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the very heart of your house. Your children like olive plants all around your table. I pray that indeed the Lord will bless you as you are empowered with the knowledge, the scientific knowledge that I have shared with you today. You do not overlook the promises of God. And especially the fact that He says that children are an inheritance from Him. I pray that the scripture that I've shared with you today from Psalm 128, verse 3, builds hope in you. The Lord will bless your household with children as a gift from Him alone. That's it for this video. I truly hope that it's been helpful, informative, and that you would consider subscribing to our channel and share the reliable piece of information that we discuss on this channel. I look forward to seeing you in our next video, but in the meantime, there are plenty of topics that can whet your appetite until we meet again. Take care and we'll see you later.